Hey ma'am, in this video I'm going to explain the concept of function with no arguments and no return type. So with an example of swapping two numbers by using the concept of functions. So this is my header file. So this is my function declaration. So here I am declaring one function and my function name is swap. So the return type is void. So because I don't want to return anything to my main function. So that's why I am taking my return type as void. And you can observe that I didn't pass any arguments to my function. So it accomplish function with no arguments, no return type. So now I am trying to implement the program. For swapping two numbers using functions concept. So see, this is my main function. So simply I return one printf statement. So in main function we are calling swap function. So because simply one statement I am trying to display, that is of my own interest. If you are not interested, then don't write this printf statement. So simply what we have to do in main function, we are trying to call swap function. So this is of a void, we don't have any return type, we simply call with a function name, that is enough. So this is return 0 because my main function is of type integer, so that I am written my last statement as return 0 in my main function. So this is definition of my function. So this is a definition. Definition of swap function. So this is a function calling. Okay. So in this definition, so I have to write the logic for doing the swap operation. Okay. So now this is my variables a, b, and temp. I'm declaring these two variables for taking the values from the keyboard. And I am using one more variable temp because I need to swap these two values of a and b. So by using printf and scanf statement, simply I am trying to read the values of a and b. And after that, so this is a logic for swapping two numbers. Okay, I just explained through with a small example. Suppose if your a is 25. And your b is 36. So these are the values which you are given for a and b. And after swapping, you are expected your output is a equals to 36, b equals to 25. So for doing this, we are taken one more variable temp. And now the value of a is assigned to this temp. So now temp equals to 25 because the a value is I'm assigned to my temp variable, and after that a is assigned with the value of b, so now a will becomes to 36, and then b is assigned with the value of temp, so now it is 25. So in this way the logic will works to swap two numbers. Why? Because if I'm not using any temporary variable and I'm trying to swapping of these two numbers, then the values it will be overlapped. So because of that reason I am using one temporary variable. I can store a value in that temporary variable first before it copied from b, and after I am copying the content of b to a, I just copy the value of a from temp to b. So simply I return a printf statement. So which will display the value of a and b after swapping. So those two values are of integers. So that's why the reason I'm using percentile d's here. And here I'm using slash t for giving a horizontal tab. So now my result is at a and b. So that's why here I'm given a comma b. So now we'll see how this program it will execute. So your compiler starts execution from main function. So it will print in main function we are calling swap function, and after that whenever the function call is there, So whenever you are calling the function call, then what's happening? The compiler will jumps, right? The controller will go to the definition of the swap function. So before it takes the definition, so it will check whether this function is declared or not. Okay, that function is already declared. So now it will take the definition, because it will check the prototypes, whether your declaration of your function and the definition both are same or not, right? So it is also possible you can write any number of functions in your same program. So here I am written only one function. So because my aim is to swap two numbers, so then it will see the declaration of these three variables, and after that it will read A and B values from the keyboard, and it will do the logic for swapping of these two numbers as I just mentioned, and after that it will print the values in A and B after swapping. Now again it the controller will came back to the main function, and it will see the return 0 as a last function, then it exit from the main function. So now I'll show you how to compile and execute this program. So see, in main function we are calling the swap function. So this statement is printing from the main function, and after that, so the swap function is called. Because of that, it will ask you enter the values of A and B. So now I'm entering the value of A equals to 25, B equals to 36. And we expected the value of A is 36 and B is 25 after swapping. So just click on enter button. See, the value of A and B after swapping is 36 and 25. I think you all understand. Thank you.